The Bucks are always hyped to play in front of their home crowd, and tonight's no different. Some confident players coming through the tunnel earlier on. Welcome and happy holidays from 2K Sports. It's time for NBA action. This is Kevin Harlan. Courtside with Greg Anthony and Brent Beery. David Aldridge will join us momentarily from the sidelines. Hey, Dave.
Thanks very much. Now, D'Angelo Russell says he patterns his game after another crafty lefty. He said, if I could model my game after somebody, it would be Manu Ginobili. He was never the most athletic, but he could pass, he could score, and he was just so unpredictable. Not a bad role model for D'Lo. Kevin?
Not at all. Yeah, some similarities definitely there, David. Thank you. With the All-Star game approaching, Brent, there are plenty of deserving players, but as we know, there are only 12 coveted spots for each roster.
And Kevin, get ready for all the snub talk that we hear every year. It comes along like rain in spring. But if you could see the league expand the rosters maybe to 13, maybe even 15 players, yeah, maybe some of that would go away. Not all of it, but maybe some.
And checking out Minnesota's opening lineup. Sliding in at the wing, it'll be Edwards and McDaniel. Rudy Gobert is out there with Kyle Anderson. And it's Russell in at the point. And for Milwaukee, Middleton, the small forward, with Giannis Antetokounmpo as the power forward. Holiday and Allen have guard duties, and it's Lopez in at the center position. Now here is Holiday. Back to Giannis. Fades and shoots. He's off on that one, and it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way. Defeated by the Pelicans in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
They're so close in that one, but that's of no solace to the players. They played their hearts out.
You want to respond in kind, but that last game, it was an effort that most of the time can get you a win. They ran into a tough opponent who was playing at a high level.
A nice shot there by Antetokounmpo.
Well, you have to do way more than that to stop the MVP. Giannis just determined.
And you love seeing that great mobile one drive a second time.
And you gotta love the aggression that he had taking it to the rim there. Sets the tone in a close game like this one.
Oh, here's Edwards. He had a 27-point outing in their last game against the Pelicans in New Orleans.
And if you look at his free throw numbers, you can see what kind of pressure he put on the defense. He was in attack mode all night long.
Now here is Holiday. Anthony Edwards unable to get his last shot to go in. Back to Giannis. Six on the shot clock. Minnesota with the rebound.
And listen, sometimes even the best of us are going to miss the easiest of opportunities.
Gobert with a screen on Allen. Edwards passes to Gobert. And finished off by Gobert.
And when Gobert is making a move to the bucket, it's best to just stay out of the way. There is a lot of momentum behind the big fella. And one of the biggest stories of the summer was Rudy Gobert being traded. Gets a fresh start with the Timberwolves. Really, the right play defensively. If you can't block, force him to the line.
You know, Brent, hard to believe that back in 2017, Giannis was winning Most Improved Player.
Well, it's been unbelievable growth, and it seems so long ago that Giannis came into this league, but we've been inundated with Antetokounmpo highlights in the biggest moment that the league has to offer, winning an MVP in the league, a Finals MVP. And there's no question that Giannis has grown into one of the best that has ever played for the Milwaukee Bucks, and maybe one of the best ever.
First free throw is good. The Timberwolves secured a spot in the playoffs last season, Greg, and we enjoyed it after they got that emotional win in the play-in game in the Twin Cities over the Clippers. What a night.
And Kevin, you could tell it meant a lot to the players. This is a team that has struggled for so long, and by getting to the playoffs, this is a step in the right direction.
We got this. And both free throws good for Giannis. And Greg, even with teams daring Giannis to shoot from outside, his career three-point percentage stuck below 30%.
And still an elite scorer because of his proficiency at the rim. But it's been said before, if he adds the triple, he'll be truly unguardable. And what a creative finisher. Edwards is so fast in how he gets up to throw it down.
Nice job capturing the moment on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Now here is Holiday. Scoring-wise, he's definitely making his mark. Right now, he's averaging about 19 points a game. Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession. Almost halfway through the season, let's check out the standings in the East. Taking a look at Milwaukee. Right now, they've compiled the third-best record in the conference.
And right now for the Bucks, they had pressure on them coming into the season. A lot of people were picking them to have a special year. And they haven't shied away from that pressure. They've embraced it.
I think every great team welcomes the challenge of trying to be elite. And they want to do it on a nightly basis.
Edwards against Allen. 2 points. That one goes.
And early on, they've been nearly perfect from the floor. Just the one miss here on their first five attempts.
Allen outside. There's the pass to Giannis. Gobert with the block.
And the reach and height of Gobert, it literally makes it impossible to score over him. He's able to get all over that shot.
And Antetokounmpo gets it to go.
Uncovered at the rim, finding cracks in the defense here early on.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
Here's Gobert. Giannis Antetokounmpo making his last shot.
And if he gets looks that cleanly, Gobert becomes unstoppable. He makes good use of his body and just wills himself to a foul.
Minnesota shooting their first free throws of the game. And he can't get the first one. Good on the second free throw.
An improved free throw shooter compared to his earlier seasons. Nice to see Gobert attack his weakness.
Antetokounmpo against Anderson. Antetokounmpo, no good.
No doubt it's been a bit of a struggle for him here in this quarter in terms of scoring.
Sweet move. A nice shot by McDaniel.
And the story here, Kevin, early on is how well they've shot the basketball.
Now here is Holiday. He's still scoreless so far in this one. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Appreciate Drew Holiday getting shifty there on the inside to draw the contact.
And a moment now to quickly take a look at the offensive approach for the Timberwolves.
And guys, they've done a great job feeding their bigs inside. They are just punishing the opposition in the paint.
And let's make sure that that selfish nerve doesn't get tapped, because right now there's great ball movement. They're setting each other up. Let's see if that maintains.
Portis, he's checked in for Milwaukee. Pat Connaughton comes in for Allen. So he gets them both.
A great player on a great roll at the charity stripe. The D has got to be careful about being too aggressive on him and sending him back for freebies.
Oh, here is Edwards. He seems to always be finding ways to score, averaging around 23.5 points a game. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. Bucks trail by four. Holiday, the pass to Connaughton. Portis, a screen on Edwards. Pass to Portis. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. That's on Jaden McDaniels.
The physicality that Bobby Portis brings to the game is something that his teammates really get behind. It makes him such an effective player out there, impacting the attitude of so many.
Free throw good. Portis. A different look for Milwaukee. Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Lopez. Joe Ingles comes in for Chris Middleton. And it's Carter in for Drew Holiday. The Timberwolves also changing it up. Torian Prince, he's checked in for Rudy Gobert. Noel comes in for Edwards. And it's Austin Rivers in for Russell. That one is no good. Timberwolves leading by three. Pass to McDaniels. The dish to Prince. And here's Rivers. He's averaging around 5.5 points a game. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. A shot by McDaniels. No good. Looking at the last game for the Bucks, it was a loss to the Bulls in Chicago.
I'll tell you, they played hard, they drew fouls, but they could not convert at the line.
Yeah, drawing fouls is tough, but the important part about that is when you get to the free throw line, you've got to turn those into points, and it might have cost them in that last ball game missing all those chippies.
Here's Noel after the made shot from Bobby Portis. 1:41 left in the first quarter. Here's Noel. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Carter, the pass to Portis. Reed with the block. And that's out of bounds. Milwaukee will retain possession. Now, Ingles. No points in the game hit for him. Clock at four. Fades back. Portis can't get it to go.
His touch from mid-range, that's almost always good. That won't shake his confidence.
Rivers scanning the floor. To the inside. Knocked away. It's stolen by Ibaka. Pass to Connaughton. Out to Carter. The pass to Ingles. The tray. It's hauled in by Noel. Minnesota leading by three. 26 seconds left in the first quarter of the game. And so it's Ingles with it. He brings it up for the Milwaukee Bucks. And Carter has it in the corner. They get it again. Portis can't get it to go.
He's so good at getting to the rim. Maybe tries to get a little bit too cute with that one. I thought he'd lay it straight up and in.
Here's Noel. A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. The Timberwolves lead by three. And we'll get going after this from Milwaukee. Close game through the first quarter, and we'll see what happens here in the second. And let's quickly break down the game we're watching with the Timberwolves, guys.
Stingy on the defensive end in that first quarter. They were just getting up into people.
Just a great job, really, of making the game ugly, trying to muck it up a little bit out there.
In decades past, teams that led the league in threes, if they shot that same right now, would rank, Greg, dead last in the NBA. So with that thought, which teams of yesteryear probably should have shot more threes?
And that's a good one, Kevin. I think you got to look back to the Run TMC Warriors, right? How about the Larry Bird Celtics? Man, they could knock down the triple.
Giannis and Lopez hold down the post for him. And the wings for him, Matthews and Middleton. And it's Holiday in at the one spot. So that's who Milwaukee starts the second.
This is the variety of ways Lopez can hurt you. He can be in the pick and pop. He can be in the roll. A lot of options from the big man.
Now, here is Russell. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. And the rejection by Antetokounmpo. It's Antetokounmpo on the wing. And then jammed down as he goes right over Kyle Anderson.
I think Giannis loves that kind of stuff right there. His dunks sometimes get vicious.
Russell finds Edwards. And here's Gobert. Pass to Russell. Driving inside. Passes to Forbes. For three. Bangs home the trifecta. Forbes has got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game.
The defense better make sure they're sticking to all four other players, or else D'Angelo is going to find the open man.
Pass to Holiday. Banked in off the glass. Holiday's got it all tied up now for Milwaukee.
Drew's got such a great build, 205, 210 pounds, a bigger guard. Hard to knock him off of his shot.
Now here's Edwards. Outside Russell. Gobert with a screen for Russell. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
And now in the final year of his contract, D'Angelo Russell trying to get back to that all-star level and the promise that got him that last four-year deal.
And after a lackluster performance in last year's playoff, Russell has some making up to do.
Yeah, and the efficiency has been a problem. Now, if you're a player whose primary value is at the offensive end, you can't just be a volume scorer.
He misses the free throw. No luck that time either. The Bucks have gone a nice 3-3 to start the second. Now the pass to Lopez. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Chris Middleton.
Chris Middleton.
That is his first foul of the game.
First team foul.
The Timberwolves shooting has been terrific. 54% on the game. Russell inside, guarded by Holiday. Forbes dishes to Russell. Gobert with a screen on Lopez. Russell passes to Gobert. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And the length of Gobert can be so difficult to deal with. And that's why you have to be physical with him on defense.
A free throw drops for Gobert. So 1-for-2 that time at the stripe. Brent, when we talk about the evolution of basketball, Brooke Lopez is a great example.
Well, this is one of the more head-scratching, remarkable, complimentary things that you could say about Brooke Lopez. The fact that he did not make a three-pointer until his seventh season in the NBA, but added that long range to his game to become a stretch five and a valuable piece to the Bucks' 2021 title run. An amazing career arc for one Brooke Lopez.
Milwaukee making a switch here. Allen's checked in. So looking it over. And Gobert kicks to Forbes. Gobert with a screen on Allen. Forbes the pass to Gobert. Score the basket. His second of two attempts.
And not the same skinny guy he was when he entered the league. Gobert a lot less affected by contact these days.
Now here is Holiday. Antetokounmpo finds Lopez. The Bucks working the ball around. There's the triple. Milwaukee, no good that time either.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Pass to Edwards. At the top of the key, Gobert. Back to Edwards. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It goes on Chris Middleton. And you look at Anthony Edwards. And G.A., he is becoming the leader of this Timberwolves team, isn't he?
I think he is. I mean, partly it's his production with his numbers up across the board, but it's also his personality. He plays with tremendous swagger.
He throw good, Edwards.
As we've gotten closer to halftime, their style has become more and more physical.
George Hill's checked in for Chris Middleton. The Timberwolves also with a sub. McDaniels, he's checked in for D'Angelo Russell. And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
And talented in so many ways. Edwards is focusing on two things: the refining of his shot mechanics and the sustained level of engagement.
Now here's Giannis. He's got eight. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the content.
Second personal foul.
Here's what the Timberwolves have lined up on their schedule. On Saturday, they'll go back home and they'll be hosting the Detroit Pistons. And then on Monday, they'll face off against DeAndre Jordan and the Denver Nuggets.
And for their matchup with the Clippers, you know they're going to be amped up for that one. And they'll need to be. That's going to be one tough game for that group.
Free throw good. Giannis.
Of course, one of the league's best scorers. Giannis poised to be one of the game's all-time best.
A different look for Milwaukee. Bobby Portis comes in for Brook Lopez. And it's Pat Connaughton in for Drew Holiday. Timberwolves also changing it up. Noel comes in for Edwards. And it's Rivers in for Bryn Forbes.
We got this.
He doesn't get the second one. Timberwolves leading by four. Right now, I'd send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Thanks very much, Kevin. Well, of course, Giannis is the Bucks leader, but it's still Coach Bud who calls the shots. Giannis says, as players, we have to accept Coach's plan. You got to trust. That's the only way it's going to work. And sometimes it won't. Sometimes I'm going to execute the game plan, and sometimes I'm not. Not because I don't want to, but it's just not my day. Kevin, that is very, very good perspective.
Agreed. Thanks, David. Here's Allen. Rudy Gobert picking up that last basket. Back to Portis. From past the arc. And it's Rivers with the rebound. Minnesota's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. This is it to Noel. Pass to Anderson. Gobert trying to get open. Anderson's shot is off. Bucks trail by six. And the pass to Hill. Good, and the assist goes to Giannis.
Well, that Greek freak nickname is apropos. I mean, he can handle it, he can pass it. A combination of size and athleticism. What a talent.
Now here's Rivers. Nothing yet on the scoreboard for him. And finished off by Anderson.
Austin making Rivers. The most of the screen. That's how it's done.
And it's in the perfect spot, Greg. Frees him up to get all the way to the bucket.
Really not enough help there. Lack of communication on the backside.
And that's just taking advantage of some soft defense on that drive. Little resistance for him on the way to the basket.
It's Rivers on the wing. They get the rebound. Launches a three. And another shot. And Gobert with the lay-in. Gobert's got 10.
And Kevin, they dialed up their activity this quarter. We're seeing them convert a lot of those second chance opportunities.
Portis kicks to Connaughton. Outside Hill. On the wing, Giannis. The 11-footer. No good off the front iron.
Well, he wants to shoot his way out of this cold spell, but the struggles continue.
Yeah, he's got to move on, forget about this sequence here, and try to find a way to get on the board.
Now, here's Anderson. They lead by six, their biggest margin. Antetokounmpo with the ball. Last time, 45 points for him. Rebounded by the Timberwolves. Gobert has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Here's Rivers. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. And now it's an 8-point Timberwolves lead.
Well, the problem defensively after Rivers gets a step is nobody sliding over in time to slow him down.
3-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Here's Antetokounmpo. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Third personal foul.
It goes on Kyle Anderson.
Yeah, easy call.
This is his third trip to the free throw line in the game.
Giannis Antetokounmpo taking 2 shots.
That's good from Antetokounmpo. He hits one and misses one, each at the line.
And battling hard on the glass, they hold the advantage here so far.
Prince, the pass to Noel. Can't hit from in close. And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves bringing the quarter to a close with a 7-point lead. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David, thanks for the great interview, David. We'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
Thanks for tuning in. Did you miss us? Before we discuss the game at hand, let's first check out the upcoming schedule.
Going home could be exactly what they need right now. They haven't been at their best, but sleeping in your own bed can do wonders. Hopefully this helps them recharge and put the last stretch behind them.
And now, guys, let's take a minute to discuss Rudy Gobert and how he had his fingerprints all over that first half.
Feels like he's tracking down every missed shot. Straight up, he's outworking the guy across from him. Fantastic effort.
And if you're the other team, you have to get a body on him. Box him out, man.
And that about wraps it up. And as the third quarter is about to begin, we go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
Yeah.
and happy you could join us. We've got two quarters left to go in regulation.
Yeah, and I don't know if anybody saw this offense coming from him, but it's been key for his team.
Yeah, and I'm not sure coming into this game he felt like he could dominate in the way he's doing so now. Been phenomenal.
And on the floor for Chris Finch as we get into the second half. Backcourt guards are Russell and Edwards. McDaniels is out there with Kyle Anderson. And it's Gobert in at the five.
And this is why Giannis is up there every season as one of the league leaders in dunking the basketball. Just way too easy.
Now one against Edwards. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Edwards got 8 points.
An agile move off the contact by Edwards, getting to his shot despite the difficult defense.
Antetokounmpo inside. Working on Anderson. Basket good. Antetokounmpo has got 4 points now in the quarter.
And he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Up top, Edwards, defended by Allen. Edwards against Allen. Out to the right wing. Here's McDaniels. Oh, my! He'll go to the line with a chance for a four-point play. It goes on Chris Middleton. And this is his first trip to the line tonight. The Bucks making a switch here. Portis is checked in. Free throw drops for McDaniels. And here's Middleton bringing it up now for Milwaukee. They trail by 9 points. The Wizards on the road to face them after this game. And that will be the middle game of this three-game homestand. Now here's Middleton. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Russell against Holiday. Milwaukee needs to get off a shot here. Lopez. Misses the three, and he used the pump fake well there, but he couldn't capitalize. Anderson outside. He kicks it to McDaniels. Sinks the three-pointer. McDaniels got two now from beyond the arc in the third for Minnesota. Bucks trail by 12. Middleton outside. Holiday looking over the floor. Allen outside. Will it go? Gobert with the block. And so the ball out of bounds. Gobert touched it last. Matthews, he's checked in for the Bucks. Touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Holiday gets the bucket.
Pretty sure the defense thought they had him cornered. Nah, they didn't. Drew Holiday hits him with a big shot there as the shot clock winds down.
Anderson outside. Two free throws coming up and they call the shooting foul.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
The Timberwolves have gone 5 of 9 at the line.
And their success rate on the season, right around 77%.
First one falls for.
Tough to match up with Kyle Anderson because of how quirky he plays. Changing speeds, plays slow, but sees the floor remarkably well.
Bryn Forbes, he's checked in for Rudy Gobert. and he makes both free throws.
Well, a big fellow with the ability and confidence at the free throw line is something that every team wants. Don't have to make those late substitutions. Keep your big guys on the floor.
Now here is Holiday. He's got seven. Middleton on the wing. Edwards defending.
Anderson with the block.
Good intensity on defense. Kyle Anderson using the length that time and timing it well to get the rejection.
And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for two.
And let's briefly take a look at the stats for Middleton. How's the last month of basketball been for him? He's averaging 11 points a game, 4 assists, and 2 rebounds. And you look at his skill set, and I think it's just a matter of time before he commands a bigger presence on this team.
Yeah, just a bit rough around the edges, but he has the tools. He just needs to sharpen them.
He's off on the first.
Probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that much.
Absolutely. Hill, he's checked in for the Bucks. The Timberwolves also with a sub. Reed's checked in. And the second free throw, good. Bucks trail by 12. Hill looking around. Pass to Matthews. Lopez outside. A three. A rebound by the Timberwolves.
It's a +5 advantage for them in rebounding after that.
And Edwards with the stuff.
Oh, great work by Edwards to get up court in a hurry and get himself a bucket. Can't let those fast break opportunities get away.
And Milwaukee calls their first timeout of the game.
You know what time it is, Bucks fans. Give it up for your
Prince has checked in for McDaniels. So a moment now to see the story for Drew Holiday. And the Bucks with possession here. It's a 14-point game. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. It goes on Torian Prince.
Great body control from Holiday. Gets the shot off while getting hit in the process.
And this is his second trip to the line tonight.
And he's at nearly 90% from the free throw line this season, so having a terrific year.
That free throw good from Drew Holiday.
And there's so many plays where Drew Holiday will show you just how creative he can be with the basketball.
Serge Ibaka, he's checked in for Lopez. Both free throws good from Holiday. Timberwolves leading by 12. It's Edwards on the wing. And Edwards with the stuff.
And we are seeing tonight why Edwards was selected first overall. Anthony has a special ability to score.
Now here is Hill. He's averaging a bit over 5 points a game. Ibaka finds Holiday. The Bucks working the ball around. Hill passes to Portis, and the officials call him for a 3-second violation.
And now a look at the numbers for Edwards. He's been dominant over the last month. First in steals, and he's right up there in the top 20 in scoring. Certainly a force to be reckoned with offensively.
And as you said, number one in steals this season. He's the sneakiest ball hawk in the league right now. Hide everything you've got, because he's coming after you. Now, here's Reed. 14 points, their largest lead in the game. Back to Rivers. 4 on the clock.
That one misses.
So Milwaukee will take it the other way.
Hill against Rivers. Matthews passes to Ibaka. Drills the three-pointer. Ibaka's got himself going there. His first points of the game with the deep ball.
Wow, something's brewing, guys. The three-pointers just continue to flow.
Here's Edwards. Good D by Matthews.
Well, if you believe in the numbers, that mid-range shot is not a high-value shot, even with little or no defense on you.
Rivers against Hill. Passes to Connaughton. A three ball. And another three for Milwaukee.
They'll be with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been from beyond.
And sometimes we see players who could have been pros in another sport. Pat Connaughton is one of those guys. It's been well documented that he played both basketball and baseball in college and was actually drafted in 2014.
And with Connaughton, there was no question he had a shot as a pro pitcher.
Well, a tribute to how athletic and how talented Pat was is as a pitcher, he had a mid-90-mile-per-hour fastball, which is tremendous when you think about it. It's fantastic that he's been able to carve out this career after the first couple seasons where it was on the brink, where he might have gone to Europe or back to baseball.
Free throw good, Edwards. A different look for Milwaukee. Giannis, he's checked in for Bobby Portis. Joe Ingles comes in for Wesley Matthews. And it's Carter in for Hill. Noel, he's checked in for Minnesota. And he can't hit the second. And they'll get another chance. Kicks to Rivers. Prince outside. Let's it go with a three. Another miss by Minnesota. Bucks trail by nine. Giannis against Prince. Here's Antetokounmpo. And that one hits back iron. Minnesota's gone into the three-point range four times since halftime and buried two of them. Noel passes to Reed. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Bucks have gone even 5 of 10 on shot attempts in the third. Connaughton kicks to Antetokounmpo. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
First personal foul.
Great to see Antetokounmpo going strong inside. At times, the D has no choice but the foul.
And it'll be his fourth time going to the free throw line of the game.
Two shots.
And he knocks down the first one. And the Timberwolves making a change here. Gobert's checked in. And so he's able to get one of two. Minnesota leading by eight. Shot clock and game clock separated by less than 6 seconds. Here's Noel. He's defended by Connaughton. Here's Noel. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11 and a half points a game.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now, trying to put this one away.
And so it's Minnesota. Their lead at 11 points to end the quarter. Their defense has been active and effective. We've got more in store for you right after this. And now let's go back to a play from earlier as we show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, a great job with the eyes. And what separates great playmakers, as we know, is peripheral vision.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Bucks trail by 11. A talented pair of Middleton and Giannis in at forward. Carter out there with Holiday, and it's Lopez in at the center filling out the middle. That's the five on the floor for the Bucks. And that one's good on Nkumbo.
Sometimes Giannis waits to take over a game. Not tonight. This is epic.
On to Nkumbo against Anderson. Has to Gobert. Anderson trying to free himself up. Gobert can't hit. The Bucks shooting 38% from the field. A pretty weak showing for them. And that one's good by Giannis.
And this is the final piece. Giannis being able to shoot threes. Whew, that's scary.
Here's Noel. Guarded by Holiday. Left side, Anderson. Outside, Russell. Loads from nine. That one wide left. The Bucks trail. Inside. And the slam dunk by Antetokounmpo.
Well, an outstanding floor general right there. Holiday has switched between point guard and off guard. And a great feel for when guys are open.
Russell against Carter. Gobert with a screen on Carter. Russell passes to Gobert. And slam dunk by Gobert.
And no issues at the rim for Gobert. One of the league leaders in flushes. The Frenchman loves to finish above the rim.
The pass to Holiday. Knocked loose. And it's out of bounds. The Bucks able to retain possession here. And the Bucks making a change here. Allen's checked in. And the Timberwolves also making a change. Bryn Forbes, he's checked in for Noel. Anderson against Giannis. And the double up out of Nkumbo. Shot clock at six. Lopez, no luck. Timberwolves leading by six. Forbes dishes to Russell. It's stolen by Allen. And here we go with Allen running it up the court. Anderson with the block. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Anderson. Let's take a second look at that fantastic block.
Quick thinking pays off big. What a block.
Edwards has come in for Minnesota.
Anthony Edwards.
Goes up off the inbound, and Giannis hits it to go. On the assist by Lopez.
And he's coming up big here in the clutch.
Minnesota calls timeout.
Called for Minnesota.
Able to listen in on what Chris Finch told the team. He was very fired up. He said, look, this is going to be a big win for us. We close this out and we'll show the rest of the league who we are.
Thank you, David. Just a little under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Here's Edwards. The rebound by the Bucks. Now here's Middleton. A dishes it to Allen. Good, and the assist goes to Middleton. Middleton's got three assists in the game. And it's Russell with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. And at home for the next game, it'll be Detroit pulling into town. And that game will kick off a four-game homestand. Pass to Anderson. He dishes it to Edwards. Just three to shoot. The three. And the rejection by Giannis. And the dunk by Giannis.
So impressive. The fortitude, the will to battle back, but it did take a lot of energy to get here.
Well, they didn't really have a choice at the position that they were. They had to fight hard. They've gotten that. They've outworked the other team just fighting.
For three, Edwards. He scores a sixth bucket from the floor with that one. He's shot the ball 11 times.
Making the easy shots and the tough shots. He's on top of his game.
Giannis against Anderson. And they double up Giannis. Allen kicks to Holiday. Lopez, a screen on Russell. Holiday, the pass to Lopez. Tries again. He takes it up and lays it in.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
For Minnesota, they've gone just 33% for the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. Gobert. And finished off by Gobert.
It's Gobert showing some guts on that one. With that length, a good bet to get off a good look in that crucial moment.
Here's Antetokounmpo. Rudy Gobert with the rebound. Gobert's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight. Here's Anderson. And the rejection by Giannis. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. There's the feed to Anderson. Back to Russell. Down low.
Good hustle from the big man there. Love seeing Lopez work hard, get down low, make a difference on this end.
Just five on the clock. To the wing on the left. Here's McDaniels. Off target from three-point range. Bucks trail by three. The double up out of the Kumba. And D'Angelo Russell picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him.
First team foul.
1:52 left to play in the final quarter. And the double up out of the Kumba. Holiday, no one around him. And again, Milwaukee with the triple.
And really, that is a tremendous shot by Holiday there. His team really has momentum now.
Minnesota calls timeout. It's tied at 57. 1:43 left to play here in the fourth.
Let's give a big welcome to the floor. Your Fallen Forward.
1:43 left in the fourth quarter. Allen against Edwards. Gobert with a screen on Allen. For three, Edwards. A rebound by the Bucks. Giannis has got 8 rebounds in this game. Allen with it. Picked up by Edwards. Allen, that's good. Allen's got the lead up to 2 now for Milwaukee.
And that was the right call. When you need a basket, go to the guys you trust the most.
Yeah, whether it's teammates or the coaching staff, hopefully a combination of both, but gets close, he's getting the ball.
Here's Gobert, and he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. That's on Brook Lopez.
And everyone is counting on him. Gobert needs to be at his best here. It's all about execution.
And a closer look here at the hustle stats for the Bucks.
A high-effort brand of defense has been paying off for them in this one. They've managed to either block or alter a ton of their opponent's shots.
Well, if we add another thing to it, it's about the urgency they've played with. I mean, you look at the eyes of these guys. They're focused, wanting to get up-tempo, and that's helped them score on the fast break.
And Gobert drops them both.
You might want to think twice before sending him to the line again. He gets locked in when the game gets close.
Here's Antetokounmpo, and they get it back. Allen finds Antetokounmpo. Middleton up top. He's guarded by Russell. Back to Antetokounmpo. Four on the shot clock. Gobert pulls it in.
That might not be the shot they want him taking, even with the D backing off.
Here's Edwards. Milwaukee with the rebound. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Outside, Antetokounmpo. Lopez sets a screen for Antetokounmpo. Stolen by McDaniels. It's Edwards on the wing, guarded by Holiday, and out of bounds as the Bucks gain possession.
Man, the score being this close, you have to retain possession of the ball. You just can't give it away like that.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. It's tied at 59. 11 seconds left in the game. Against Anderson. Lopez, a screen on Anderson. And regulation now complete. We will go to overtime. And we'll get going after this from Milwaukee. Time in what has been a stirring contest. And here is Antetokounmpo. Holiday and Allen have guard duties. Middleton, the small forward, with Giannis Antetokounmpo as the power forward. And it's Lopez in at the five. Home in the paint.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Now Russell. Passes it to Anderson to the middle. It's tipped. Lopez with the steal. Antetokounmpo against Anderson. Pass to Middleton. Anderson against Antetokounmpo. Lopez, a screen on Anderson. Six to shoot. Antetokounmpo trying to break loose. Lopez, no luck. And it's Anderson with the ball for Minnesota. Trailing by two. Russell with a wide open look. It's good, and they get the go-ahead bucket.
Well, D'Angelo Russell not scared of the big moment.
Well, the Bucks shooting 43% from the field. And there's the pass to Middleton. Now here's Allen, trying to go for an alley-oop, but excellent defense and anticipation there to stop it. Edwards looking it over. Takes the 13-footer. That one a little long.
Not a bad shot from the mid-range. D's giving it to him, and he's usually got an eye on that kind of range.
And they double up Antetokounmpo. He's looking for Lopez and finds him. Gobert with the defensive effort. 1:19 left in the first overtime. Action has been terrific. McDaniels kicks to Edwards. Shot clock at five. He's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line.
People are are holding their breath a little, wondering if Edwards can take care of business here.
He hits the first one, and that will put them up by two. Gets them both, and it's a three-point game.
And you just have to understand that hours and hours of practice mean that clutch free throws become easy.
Here's Antetokounmpo. Draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
That is world class.
Love seeing that there. A huge possession, and he nets it.
He knocks down the clutch free throw.
Yeah, big play on the front end to finish, despite getting hacked there, and big on the back end to hit the free throw.
Minnesota calls timeout. It's tied at 64. 51 seconds left in the first overtime.
You know what time it is, Bucks fans. Give it up for your 4-by-4 crew.
So it's Minnesota now. Anderson dishes to Edwards. Fires from deep. And Chris Middleton pulls it down. Giannis against Edwards. Shoot from 12. Giannis, no good. And the Timberwolves with possession. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game. Right side, Edwards. There's the three. Lopez grabs the board. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. There's 18 seconds left to play in OT, and this battle continuing. Time, they've got a chance to take the lead.
By far the biggest possession of this game.
Holiday against Russell. To the paint. Holiday with the three. Oh, and a chance to win the game, but the last second shot is offline. And so we are tied again at the end of overtime. Now we're headed to overtime number two. We've got more in store for you right after this. And with another overtime in front of us, the question is, who will blink first? Nobody wants to give in. A lot of pride now on the line. Edwards against Allen. Edwards passes to Gobert. And finished off by Gobert.
And showing he can make plays for others. Edwards moving it with conviction.
Holiday against Russell. Rebound Minnesota. Russell's got 4 rebounds now tonight. There's the dish to Edwards. Gobert with a screen on Allen. Edwards passes to Gobert. Holiday against Russell. And Holiday kicks to Middleton. Back to Holiday. Down to five on the shot clock. Pass to Allen to take the lead. The rebound by Anderson. Anderson's got his fifth rebound in this one. Down low. And Edwards with the stuff.
And the more experience Edwards gets, the better he'll become, especially when he's stepping up and hitting the big shots.
And Antetokounmpo slams it in.
So exciting to see the growth of the Greek Freak. There are shots that stars sink, and that's a momentum changer right there.
Now one against Edwards. From 10 feet out, and the rejection by Antetokounmpo. Gobert with a screen on Middleton. Here's McDaniels.
Excellent off-ball awareness as Brook was able to get over there. Swatted away.
Pass to Antetokounmpo. And out of bounds as the Timberwolves gain possession. Here is Edwards. 109 left in the second overtime period, and here we are. Gobert. Outside, Russell. Pass to Edwards. Gobert with a screen for Edwards. Edwards with another miss.
And you get the sense that he's hit a wall here in OT. He just hasn't been much help to them at all.
Lopez pushes to Holiday. That doesn't go on the chance to tie.
Well, the D's so tight on him, it makes him alter his shot. And an easy chance turns into a tough one because the defense is swarming.
Outside, Edwards. Out to Russell. Gobert with a screen on Middleton. Here's Russell. Oh, wow, unable to get a shot off in time. And they turn it over. A very unfortunate time there to pick up the shot clock violation. Timeout called, the Bucks. They're behind by two. 11 seconds left in the second overtime. What a game. Guys, your thoughts?
Big chance here to tie it with a bucket.
Well, they just need a solid play right now, and Coach going through his index cards to find one to get something going.
Here's Giannis. It's good! And tie game. That is a huge basket right there.
Big-time shot from young Giannis there. He feels more and more comfortable in these big moments.
And the Timberwolves call time. To win it, he blocks it again.
A defensive forward so far. That's six blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. And so with overtime two in the books, the game is still not over. Overtime number three coming up. And we'll get going after this from Milwaukee. Stop now. We're ready for another extra period. What a game of basketball this has been.
Here we go.
Middleton outside to take the lead. A three-pointer is right on target. Middleton's got himself on the board with three there.
How about that shot by Middleton? Doesn't matter where it is in the game, he'll take that shot.
Edwards finds McDaniel. Now Russell. And it goes out of bounds. That one's off Holiday.
Minnesota ball.
Now Bucks on defense. 3-point lead. There's Russell with the three. Oh, and he almost had a 4-point play right there. He'll go to the line with a chance for three.
Second team foul.
That one is on Holiday.
Shooting for Minnesota. D'Angelo Russell at the line for three.
And that one misses. That one misses. And on his third shot, he finally gets it to fall.
And that might be a confidence shaker right there. Missing two out of three when you've got a chance to even the game up. That'll stick with you.
Middleton up top. And the shot goes in. Middleton's got the lead up to four now for the Bucks.
Keep your eyes on the prize. Middleton did just that and sunk the shot despite getting roughed up a bit.
That was a second look at our Mobile One drive. Amazing control on display.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Edwards kicks to Russell. Now here's McDaniel. He's covered closely and finished off by McDaniel.
Credit the screen for giving him the space he needed to get to the rim.
For sure, GA allows him to come in with the sledgehammer.
Yeah, well, he settled for the layup when you can attack the rim and rise up like that. Wow, Lopez stepping up. What confidence from the big fella.
Edwards against Allen. Edwards inside. Excellent D there from Allen.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
Adekumbo against Anderson, and foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
More and more in big games, Giannis is the guy that's going to be in this situation. Watch his focus.
And that hurts as he doesn't get the first one to fall, trying to focus now on the second.
Big trip for Giannis. Normally at the stripe, he's better in the pressure moment.
Portis, he's checked in for Brook Lopez. Able to hit the second one, and that puts them up by five. And here's Edwards. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. It's on Bobby Portis.
And this is Edwards' game. When he's aggressive and trying to score, it really puts a lot of pressure on the defense.
So the first one drops, and that shrinks the margin to just four. And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
Listen, they're still right in this thing. Missing that free throw, though, keeps this a two-possession deficit.
And now they decide to foul intentionally.
Jaden McDaniel, second personal foul. Third team foul. And at the line for the Hawks, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Taking two shots.
First free throw is good, and that puts them up by five. He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in.
And I'm sure he would like to have had all of those, but he's still able to pad the lead.
And here's Edwards from the arc. That shot off the mark. Now the Bucks take it the other way. And an intentional foul right there.
Second personal foul. Fourth team foul. That's a line for Milwaukee. Giannis Antetokounmpo. That's a line for three.
Doesn't hit the first, and that was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though. And no good on the second free throw, so he goes 0 for 2 there. 8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Here's Edwards. And oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two.
Second personal foul. 14 foul. At the line for the Timberwolves, Anthony Edwards.
And he misses the first one. Boy, he wanted that one to fall. Second of two is good. That shrinks the margin to just four. So Mike Budenholzer decides to take a timeout here. He can nail the second. Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. So he comes up empty, missing both. And it's Anderson with the ball for the Timberwolves. Good! And he has brought them to within 2 points.
And he is built to be the man for this team. Edwards answering the bell and executing.
And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul.
you have to foul, but I'm sure they would have liked to foul someone different.
Chris Middleton. Two shots.
He drops the first one, and that makes it a three-point lead.
One of the best free throw shooters in the league, so not only is Chris Middleton confident, his teammates and his coaching staff have to feel pretty good.
And so he drops them both. It's a four-point ballgame.
Breathe easy now. The biggest free throws in the game, and he's coming through.
And timeout called by Chris Finch. What do you think, guys?
Yeah, trying to get back in this thing. They need a score.
It's funny, at this point in the game, the coach is asking the team to be perfect. They haven't been to this point.
And a deep three from Russell. No good on the quick three. And they need to stop the clock so there's a foul.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let them dribble the game out.
At the line for the box, Chris Middleton. At the line for two.
Good on the first, and that puts them up by five.
Well, one of the things that's great about Middleton is his ability at the free throw line. I mean, this guy is around 90% for his entire career, so he knows how to get there, and he knows what to do with it.
Minnesota calls timeout. Guys, what do you think?
Still a sliver of hope.
You act fast, but without mistakes.
Your Young Bucks dancing. Give them a round of applause.
Russell from long range. Milwaukee with the rebound. And Kyle Anderson gets the whistle that time. And so he's picked up his final foul. And he will sit for the rest of this game. And he cannot get the first one to drop. Tough one to miss. Get either to fall. And so the Bucks take the win. An amazing game lasting multiple overtimes.
I mean, definitely an epic game. And while both teams fought hard, I just got the sense they played more with a purpose to win. I mean, all the tension in OT, they have got to be exhausted, but happy. What a game.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Chris. You see Giannis every day. Seems to still come up big every time.
Showing how great he is. I mean, he's been consistent all year. He's been a threat in the paint. He's been a great leader, too. So, I mean, he's having a heck of a year. And we need him to be that player, that great player for us.
He's certainly performing at that level. Congrats on the win. Back to you.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Brett Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our 2K Sports crew. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Giannis Antetokounmpo.